Adobe Photoshop is a registered trademark of Adobe Systems Incorporated. I am in no way affiliated with Adobe. Hi, I'm Steve Anthony. I'm a photographer and digital retouching artist here in New York City. In this clip, we're going to talk about how to edit photos in Photoshop. Now, editing pictures in Photoshop involves many different aspects. We're going to cover just a few of them in this particular instance. I've opened a picture here for some editing. The most basic thing you might want to do is change your levels. Now, the best way to do that is to go into Image, Adjustments, and just click on Auto Levels. Now, in this case, it lightened the picture a little bit and punched up the contrast a tiny bit. That might be all you need to do. That might do it for your picture. But let's say you want to go a little bit further. You say, well, I'd like to make the picture a little bit more intense. So let's go to Curves. Now, what Curves allows you to do is, by changing the shape of this line, change the brightness and contrast levels of your picture. In most cases, a very gentle S curve is all you're ever going to need. But this is the best way to adjust your brightness and contrast with Photoshop, because it doesn't actually discard any image information, whereas using brightness and contrast settings, which I'll show you right now. Now, this is probably easier. Adjust your brightness and contrast with these sliders. But most professionals prefer to use the Curves adjustment because it actually allows you to make changes without discarding any of the information in the picture itself. But if you're more comfortable with the brightness and contrast tools, by all means, use them. Another useful tool for editing is Hue and Saturation. You might find that your color is a little bit too intense. Using your saturation slider, bring it down. You can actually make it a black and white picture by doing it going all the way to minus 100. But you might want to punch up the color a little bit, give it a more sort of a vintage slide look. You can do some scary special effects with your color settings. I don't recommend that for my face, but some of you might find that interesting. Maybe that's too intense. So, as you can see, there are many, many different ways to edit pictures in Photoshop. I encourage you to play around and find the way that's most comfortable for you. There are immense and very, very versatile tools at your disposal in Photoshop. I'm Steve Anthony, and this has been How to Edit Pictures in Photoshop.